Chapter 1. Now, living in Ponyville as I do, and being basically neighbors with the elements of harmony, you learn to discern little things about the ponies that continuously save your flanks. For example, if Rarity were to scream right now, it would be pretty easy to judge based on intensity whether or not she was being dramatic or Baskless was about to bite her head off. Twilight Sparkle is similar. She has a few occasions where she'll scream, but it's more out of frustration than anything else. Other times she's just freaked out because, well, she is friends with Pinkie Pie. But that scream? That was something new. I'd never heard her yell out like that before. Except for once. Discord can do that to you. So I, being the ever-faithful neighbor that I am, ran outside to see what the hell I should be running back inside from. I told Daisy to stay put for all the good it would do, and ran outside. I didn't hear Twilight scream again, so I just ran for her house. It seemed I wasn't the only pony to do so either. Half the town was gathered around the library by the time I got there. To be fair, it's not a big town, but it's not a big library either, so being able to see what the hell was going on was kind of hard. There was a lot of murmuring and pointing, which was normal. My first thought was that our resident princess had gone and fucked up something magical. Again. It wasn't until I actually stopped to listen, though, that I could piece any of it together. Is she okay? Never seen her twitch like that.
Is that Derpy? What is she?
I didn't listen anymore. Ditsy Doo is a friend of mine. So I made a point to barrel my way through the crowd, or rather, just kind of nudge between a bunch of ponies that weren't that invested in where they were standing in the first place. The crowd let me go through for the most part, and then I got to the front of the pack, and couldn't see anything past the elements themselves. I also knew better than to try to force my way past all of them, especially Rainbow Dash or Applejack. I noticed that I was just inside the library at this point, so I just kind of edged around the side of the room until I could see the middle of the crowd. What I saw wasn't what I was expecting at all. I'd never seen Twilight so pale. Her friends were gathered around her, at least making a wall between her and the rest of the crowd. Ditsy Doo was standing off to the side a little, just kind of sad-looking. Over all the hushed commotion, I could hear her muttering, "I'm sorry. I really am. I'm sorry." There was a gap in the crowd on the side, or more accurately, no crowd. So I slowly made my way over to stand beside Ditsy Doo. I wanted to ask what happened, but something told me that's not a conversation she wanted to have. It was at that point I noticed all the looks she was getting. It wasn't like she usually gets. As much as I liked her, and she was my friend, there were times when I could understand some of the looks she gets. The pity, or not really scorn, just disappointment. Kind of looks you get for causing thousands in property damage or hospitalizing some pony. But this was new. This was fear. Not loathing, but you could see loathing from here. I honestly couldn't imagine what she might have done, or what it was they thought she did. So I put myself between her and the elements. Not saying anything, just kind of maneuvering between her and them. They noticed, of course, and Applejack stepped forward from the line of ponies between Twilight and the crowd outside.
"What do you think you're doing, Rose? We got a few choice words to pick with your friend."
"Look, I have no idea what's going on here, but you all look something close to murder, so I'm just going to stand here till every pony clears off," I explain. I'm still thoroughly confused as to the situation, but I'm also relatively calm. Something tells me I wouldn't be if I knew what had happened. But I do my best to ignore that pesky little voice. Ditsy says something behind me, but I don't catch it. Because at that moment, Rainbow is in my face.
"Out of the way, Rose! We need to know just what Derpy did!"
The next voice to make itself heard surprised me. Not because it was Twilight, but because I didn't recognize it as her at first. "No, she didn't do anything. Not her. It. I. What was that?" She didn't seem to be talking to any pony in particular. More like she was just reacting to whatever she heard on reflex.
"What do you mean she didn't do anything?" Rainbow yelled. "Look at you! You're a mess!"
This time Rarity spoke up.
"Rainbow, please! Have a little tact!"
She then turned her attention to Twilight, her gaze softening from a cold, scolding glare to a comforting smile.
Dear, please do tell us what it is that happened. You're obviously in a state.
At this point, at least half the crowd had lost interest, seeing as how there wasn't any immediate threat. I'm not sure why I was sticking around aside from protecting Ditsy. It wasn't even really a solid excuse. I guess just curiosity at that point. But what Twilight said next still sticks with me.
There was a thing? I don't know. It had teeth. I remember the teeth. And eyes? I don't remember eyes, or do I? Why can't I remember? There were teeth. I saw something. Teeth.
She was rambling, I could tell. I think she could too, because she kept pausing like she was trying to stop, and then more words would fall out. She actually said more after that, but it was in such a low murmur that I only really registered she was talking, because I could still see her lips move. Her friends crowded around her, all but ignoring me now. I took the opportunity to turn to Ditsy. I noticed that the rest of the crowd had meandered off, either to get away from the pale, rambling princess, or because they merely lost interest. I imagine some of them were shooed away by the more assertive members of Twilight's circle of friends. I turned to Derpy to ask her what had happened. Before I even got the words out, though, she looked up at me and said,
I'm sorry. She really shouldn't have looked. I told her not to.
She got quiet after that and just kind of wandered off, brushing past me weakly. I didn't feel like trying to stop her. Rather, I felt like I shouldn't. Her wings drooped a bit and permeating a bit of sadness. But with her face turned away, it was hard to figure out exactly what was going through her mind. She certainly looked sad enough when she spoke to me. I gave one last glance back to the elements, who were more absorbed in comforting their friend than worrying about us, which I could understand. Then I trotted after the gray Pegasus.
Derpy, wait up!